The papers called him the most notorious of the crack gangsters in his era.
Enterprising dealers went further, developing a form of cocaine that was even cheaper and packed a lot more punch.
This is it. The drug so powerful it will empty the money from your pockets, make you sell the watch off your wrist, the clothes off your back,
or kill your mother. Yep, that's what we're saying.
Samuel Baby Sam Edmondson was said to have lorded over Brownsville and East New York.
On the streets of New York, it's called crack, and the deals go down quickly. You've just witnessed a buy. This form of cocaine comes concentrated. It is smoked rather than sniffed. It produces an intense high within 5 to 10 seconds that lasts only 5 to 10 minutes and leaves the user craving for more.
And this is the most addicting thing that probably ever existed in the world. You know, it will make you a slave.
Authorities said that in Brooklyn alone, at least 9 people lay dead at the hands of Edmondson and his men within an 18-month span.
Suddenly, the war on drugs took on a whole new meaning.
I have never seen a situation like this where a drug has mushroomed so quickly and gotten such a grip on large segments of the population.
Today, we revisit the story of Samuel Baby Sam Edmondson on Up For Debate TV, Kings in New York.
It really hurt me when they killed Stan. Nobody knew who to shoot. We didn't even have a plan. He sold me my first gun. He held my first son. If I was with him shooting it out, bitch, we the one. I shed tears for my niggas who ain't here. They tattooed and spit that real shit to remember him. Bitch, I'm that dude. Catch a op and spit on his baby daughter. I'm that rude. Right at 3 o'clock as soon as he get out of school. You killed my dude. I don't give a fuck about you. I hope somebody killed you in case I never found.
Crack was a problem in almost every urban community across America in the 1980s, but it didn't become a worldwide epidemic until it began to affect a certain demographic by way of addiction, crime, and violence, the things the black community had been dealing with since day one of the crack era. Now, the reason I bring this up to you now is because the media made it seem as if Baby Sam and Crack Inc. single-handedly ushered in the wave of crack that began the entire epidemic in New York City. And hey, I don't know if that's true, and it may be, but Crack Inc. and its takedown was not about narcotics. I repeat to you, the takedown of Crack Inc. was not about narcotics. It was not due to the black-on-black violence taking place daily in our communities as allegedly 9 men lie murdered at the hands of Baby Sam and his men. Nor was it about the addiction or large multitude of drugs being sold on the streets. As an FBI agent was quoted saying that the murder of Falling Housing officer Anthony McClain prompted their investigation into Crack Inc. And I say to you, that murder affected their demographic.
The New York Times called him the head of a violent drug ring in Brooklyn. And Justice Ronald J. Aiello says that he created thousands of crack addicts destroying young lives across poor Brooklyn neighborhoods. Now, this Baby Sam story is very interesting to me in that, like I told you guys, in the beginning of this, you know, they try to make it seem as if he ushered in this wave of crack. You feel me? The epidemic, at least in New York City. You know what I'm saying? And this case wasn't even about that, if you let me tell it. You feel me? But dig this here, man. In an interview with Hype magazine, Glaze was asked who he'd had the biggest issue with during his time in the streets. Now, he said there were plenty of dangerous individuals out there, but in short, he wound up saying, Baby Sam was a hell of an individual. Would I want any problems with him? No, not if I can help it. Now, that says a lot, coming from the big homie. You know what I'm saying? The big OG, the big killer. You know what I'm saying? The feds suspected him of doing a murder per week. For what, a year or something, if I'm not mistaken? And he's saying If he could help it, he didn't want no problems with Baby Sam and them. You know what I'm saying? Now that's got to be some powerful individuals. You know what I'm saying? In one way or the next, you dig? I've only heard him speak like that about one other individual. You feel me? So that say something in itself, you know? In July of 1990, Baby Sam was sentenced to two consecutive terms of 25 years to life in prison on two murder charges, plus 12 and a half to 25 years on each of two counts of attempted murder and operating a drug enterprise. You feel me? They threw the book at him. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy as hell, man. They gave him what was that? Two consecutive terms of 25 years to life and two terms of 12 and a half to 25, man, trying to make sure he didn't never get out. And that's what the judge said. If I'm not mistaken, Justice Aiello said, if you don't die in jail, I'll be surprised, man. That's crazy as hell, man. When you put the little Aiello, that seemed like an Italian, too. It probably is. You know what I'm saying? I tried to get pictures of this dude. I couldn't. But it kept coming up Danny Aiello. And guess what he play in? All the fucking mob movies. You know what I'm saying? And I dig this here, man. This probably for a whole different time, man. But the mob had to have ties in the justice system with that type of shit happening. You got all these ILOs, Irish judges and Italian judges and whatnot, and they all connected to different mob sectors in one way, shape, form, or fashion. You feel me? So when you go before this judge, oh, he gonna stroke the shit out of you because he getting the competition out the way. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, that's for a whole different time, man, but that shit just seems strange, man. And this same judge was under investigation for something like hiring his family to do every fucking thing. You know, he hired his son as a court reporter, his daughter as a police officer, some shit like that. I got to read up over it again. But this same judge is under investigation, man. Slick bastard. Anyway, Crack Inc. was said to have terrorized East Brooklyn, killing anyone that got in their way. Then Chief Detective Robert, what is it? Colangelo was quoted as saying these were bad killers. They fired indiscriminately. They shot a lot of times. They were cold-blooded and didn't care who they killed. Now, again, I say, Blaze said if he could have helped it, he didn't want no problems with them. You know what I'm saying? Now, can you imagine that? I mean, some of you viewers I know was, fuck, your hearts was beating. My heart wasn't beating probably. You know, well, it probably was beating. It was just baby heartbeats. You feel me? But imagine being in the thick of that. With these niggas, they remind me of the best friends. Doing all the reading on these cats, because I'm going to break it down a little bit further for you, but doing the reading and investigating and research on these cats, they remind me a lot of the best friends. The best friends was a crew full of killers, first, and hustlers, second. They was millionaires, too. You feel me? Probably not to the extent that they saying Baby Sam was. You feel me? But at the same time, hey, I'm just calling it like I see it, dog. You know what I'm saying? Now, what they say, Baby Sam and Crack Inc. made from anywhere to $10,000 to $25,000 a day collectively from different spots, employing separate specialists for cooking, cutting, packaging, and selling crack, averaging a net gross of over $100,000 per day. You know what I'm saying? Now, I don't even think the feds really knew how much they really, really grossed. You know what I'm saying? Because they was only on them for a certain amount of time. That's what I'm getting at. You know what I'm saying? It ain't like they was on them for 5, 6, 7 years or something like that. They was on them for about 18 months, a little under 2 years or something like that. So they're saying that that's the money that I guess they guesstimating that they grossed during that time in action. You feel me? So they don't really know that. But if they guesstimating that, what if they was making three times that? You know what I'm saying? Straight up and down, man, because they don't know everything until somebody tell them. Now, dig, man, investigators said Baby Sam made more money than the entire Gambino organized crime family did with its unions and construction companies over the course of 630 days while under surveillance. See, that's what I was telling you. He made more money than the Gambino crime organization did with its legalities. You feel me? Motherfucking constructions and unions in a time frame of 630 days. That's about 2 years or so, right? You know what I'm saying? That's Crazy. Ain't no telling how much bread he was getting, man. I told y'all in the beginning, Justice Aiello, that's a mob motherfucking name if you ask me. You know what I'm saying? Now, what you think? He making more money than the Gambino crime organization. Then the unions and the construction companies all combined for them. You don't think them fucking Walla Wallas was trying to get him out the way? You feel me? I'm telling you, dog. Shit be running way thicker. Nothing. You know what I'm saying? I can only give it to you so much, man. I'm on some totally different shit up here, man. You want... Pardon me. Let's get back to this, man. They said, Baby Sam, he wore a $40,000 pendant with the words, "The world is mine" on it, spelled out in diamonds. And made so much money that Justice Ronald J. Aiello imposed a fine under the state's Organized Crime Control Act, a law based in part on the federal racketeering law, giving Justice Aiello the right to impose a fine three times the amount of the defendant's illicit gain. Now, for all those of you that don't know what I'm talking about, they said he made such amount of money over a time period of 630 days. The judge was able to triple that amount, basically, or whatever they calculated the amount to be, which was wound up being one of the biggest fucking fines in New York City history, as far as I know to this date. You know what I'm saying? I think it was something like $19 million in fines he had to pay back. That's crazy as a fuck. I'm supposed to pay that shit back in here working at the fucking shoe factory for 13 cents an hour, dog. You know what I'm saying? That shit crazy as a mother. How the fuck you supposed to do that? They talking about turn over every rock because we heard he got hidden assets. Well, I sure hope he did because y'all bitches tried to take everything from him. You know what I'm saying? You ain't want me. The judge said don't leave him shit but the jumpsuit on his back when he in the penitentiary. That shit was in them fucking paper, the New York Times or the New York Daily or one of them motherfucking articles, the exact article, not some extracurricular 2020 write-up. The actual article from, I think, 1989 or 1990 it was. You know what I'm saying? Shit is crazy, dog. What they say, the fine was calculated to be $6.3 million by the court's math, and they tripled that. So like I said, around $20 million, you know what I'm saying? 6, 12, 18, plus them point threes, you know what I'm saying? That's $19 million. You dig what I'm talking about? That's crazy as a motherfucker, dog. Crazy, dog. Baby Sam was a beast out here, though. You know what I'm saying? I talked to a few people, too, man. Threw my line in the water, man. Caught some fish, and they was telling me, dog. Man, this is beastly shit this nigga pulled off. And I dig this here, man. Who said this? This is a very dangerous group of individuals. Very bloody. A group of killers. To be quoted from, was a quote taken from Detective Robert Colangelo. You know what I'm saying? Very dangerous individual. Very dangerous group of individuals. Very bloody. A group of killers. Like I say, that reminds me of The Best Friends. You know what I'm saying? Real 100 shit, man. He said, one of whom prowled the streets clad in a full-length body armor with helmet. Full-length body armor with helmet, dog. Where they do that at? See, that's that Vietnam War baby shit. Niggas coming home from the war, trained machines, and all they know how to do is murder something. You feel me? Where do you get a bulletproof helmet? Where do you get body armor helmets from? I'll tell you where. The United States fucking government, the Army, the Navy, the fucking SEALs, or whatever they call it. That's where that type of shit come from. They don't just sell that shit in the gun store, especially in goddamn 1989, man. These boys were serious, you know what I'm saying? What was his name? John Amante. Serious, full-length body armor with the goddamn helmet to match, nigga. Oh my God, dig this here. The guy Victor Breland, another enforcer for Baby Sam in the Crack Inc. organization, was sentenced to 6 consecutive sentences of 25 to life in prison for murders committed on behalf of Crack Inc. as an enforcer. A group of killers, man, that got money second. You know what I'm saying? A group of murderers that got money in the meantime. You feel me? We kill your ass right now and go make a dollar 30 minutes later, man. Goddamn, man. So glad I was an 80s baby. Nigga, shout out to the 80s babies. I love you. You know what I'm saying? Ain't gonna never be nothing like us, dog. You feel me? Ain't gonna never be nothing like us. And I dig this here, man. In April of 1988, shortly after the execution of Officer Edward Bynes, I think it's Burns, Edward Burns in Queens, allegedly another member of the Crack Inc. organization by the name of Johnny Ray Robinson gunned down housing officer Anthony McLean, which ultimately took down Crack Inc., the whole enterprise, if you ask me. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say it wasn't about narcotics. It was about the narcotic and what surrounds the narcotics affecting the wrong demographic. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta pay attention, man, or shit gonna pass you by, dog. Dig this here, man. The murders of those cops affected their demographic, like I just told y'all. It wasn't about the large amounts of dope being put on the streets. It wasn't about the bodies dropped on behalf of Crack Inc. or anything like that, any of their illegal activities. It was about, hey, you can't kill a cop. You can't kill cops. You know what I'm saying? Niggas is killing cops. That's what it's about. You feel me? When Pappy and them did that, the old boy, the rookie cop. And then this is shortly after that, a housing officer gets gunned down and says, hey, this is our demographic. It's affecting us. You know what I'm saying? We let y'all fly in and give it to them. Now it's starting to hurt us and spread to our neighborhoods and the people we didn't intend to be affected by it. You know what I'm saying? The crack era, man. You look it up, man. See what I'm telling you. And I dig this here. The word I got from the streets about these dudes was, though it was Sam's organization, the general consensus is that Victor Breland, Johnny Ray Robinson, and John Amante were all capable of running their own organization and were all very dangerous men. You dig? And I dig that there because in 1987, Glaze said when he came home, Baby Sam and them approached him about joining Crack Inc. Now dig that. Is that a fucking monster team or what, my nigga? You feel me? If you add Brian Blaze Gibbs to Victor Breland, Johnny Ray Robinson, John Amante, and Baby Sam, man, I would like to see them take on the Best Friend. I would like to see them, that squad, and the Best Friends clash. That'd be a hell of a fucking meeting right there, dog. Them niggas might have ran New York. Flat the fuck out. Every side, fuck just East Brooklyn and this and that and the other flat, but them niggas might have ran New York, dog. Who knows, man? But he chose Fat Cat and them. He said Pappy and them wanted him too. He was a free agent. He said everybody wanted him to join up. I think he beat a body in 87. And when he came home, everybody wanted him to be a part of something. But he made his own choice. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy as a motherfucker, man. And I dig this here, man. When the time started coming down and the authorities got ready to pass out all that time and shit, they went to Victor Breland with a deal. And he wound up writing down all the murders he had committed, but them people wanted Johnny Ray Robinson. And he wouldn't give Johnny Ray Robinson up. And they told him no deal without Johnny Ray Robinson. The word on the streets is that he balled that piece of paper up with all them names on him and ate that bitch. Fuck you then, you feel me? True love, that's my homeboy. Fuck the rest of these niggas, you know what I'm saying? You want me to give my man? Fuck no, that's my right hand. Can't write without that bitch. I ain't write without that bitch, you know what I'm saying? Real 100 shit, that was cold blooded. So he picked it up and ate that motherfucker. That's crazy and strange. But loyalty is a motherfucker, isn't it? And I dig this here, man. A notable beef Crack Inc. had, or maybe just Baby Sam, but you know, organization's class, you feel me? Was between Delroy Uzi Edwards and Baby Sam. They went to war on the streets real heavy, I heard, and there was no real winner or loser as both sides suffered casualties in the end. You know what I'm saying? And when there's casualties on both sides, nobody never wins. And the war never ends. Shit, at least that's how we doing it. If you spill somebody's blood this way, it ain't gonna never be cool, homeboy. I don't give a fuck if you just bust his lip. If he bleeding over this shit, nigga, it ain't gonna never be. We can never be friends, nigga. You know what I'm saying? On some real 100 shit, I'm still looking for the nigga that punched me in the sandbox. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna catch that bitch too. And then when I, anyway, like I was telling y'all, it was casualties on both sides of that war, so nobody really won. And they say when they were both jailed, Delroy Uzi Edwards and Baby Sam was both jailed on Rikers Island fighting murder beefs and drug beefs all at once. And they came together in the cell block. Allegedly, Baby Sam sliced him in the face with a razor blade or whatnot. Now, this supposedly set off a chain reaction. You feel me? Because they say 2 days later, Uzi slashed the face of one of Baby Sam's associates with a box cutter during rec. And then they say 2 days following that, Baby Sam was attacked and hospitalized by two inmates, and he suffered stab wounds to the ear, elbow, back, and temple. They tried to kill that boy. The ear, elbow, back, and temple. Nigga. Stab wound to the temple or cut. That's crazy. They was trying to kill him, man. And he's still alive because I watched that the trailer, the documentary when I was doing this research for this or whatnot. It looked like it was going to be hot. They never put it out, though. You know what I'm saying? And it had him speaking. I wanted to clip a piece of him speaking, but I didn't want to clip a piece of their work like that. You know what I'm saying? Because I already got a copyright strike from this bitch, I Am Cheddar, that copyrighted my Alpo Martinez Harlem shit. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we can't get too many of them. Just got my shit back popping, you feel me? Glad y'all back with me. What y'all think of this motherfucker? I did it in a different fashion. You know what I'm saying? Y'all like how I did this here, man? Leave a thumbs up, man. Tell me how you like this in the comments, man. Did you know Baby Sam, man? Was your sister fucking him? Was your homeboy fighting him? Was you scared to go to the park when he was around that motherfucker, man? Let me know, man. Jump in the comments, man. Holler at us, dog. That's why we do this. It's an open debate. But my people say, one thing is fucking sure. Baby Sam was the truth. And he might have been the fucking king of New York. While I'm doing the kings of New York plural, he might have been the king, man. You feel me? Ozone Hold, Up for Debate TV. And you already know who it is, my baby. And you see what you see, nigga. God bless the reals. Not you fake bitch ass niggas like I Am Cheddar. Cheddar Boss Baby bitch ass nigga.